Hi everyone. In this GeoSnap, we're going to look at how using calculation attribute rules in ArcGIS Pro lets you automatically populate values when editing.
In this ArcGIS Pro project, I have a number of airplanes that I'm adding to a catalog for the Canadian Warplane Heritage Museum, and I want to set up a rule that will automatically pull the name of the airport and save it for the airport information in the aircrafts. So if we look at the attribute table, we can see that there are the name of the airport listed here. I can do this by setting up an attribute rule. So if I right-click on the feature, go into my data design and say attribute rules, we'll see that they have some rules already set up on this feature, but I want to add an additional immediate calculation rule for getting the airport name. So I'll give this rule a name and a description. I'll set the field that it's going to go to, which is airport. And then I'll set an expression. The expression is an arcade expression that will actually do the calculation for us. What this expression is doing is it's creating an airport variable that's going to pull the name of the airports from my Ontario airports layer. It's then going to create an intersection between the airports and the point feature and give us the name of that airport. It'll loop through my list and give us the name for that specific point and the airport that I want. So I'll validate this rule. And I'm going to set this on an update, so when an airplane is updated, it's going to have it, or when an airport is inserted, so a new plane is added as well. Let's save this rule, and when I go into my map, I can see that this is in effect. So let me start by selecting a feature here. I can see I have my feature, its airport is this Hamilton Airport, and I'm going to say that this airplane went for a short flight over to the Stoney Creek Airport. So let's go ahead and close the pop-up, and we're going to edit and move this airplane. And we'll zoom out and bring it over to the Stoney Creek Airport. So I'll leave that point in there, clear my selection, save the change so that the airplane has officially been moved. And now when I select on that airplane, we will see in the attributes that the name of the airport has been changed to Stoney Creek. So this is an example of how a calculation attribute rule can help you improve the efficiency of editing your data and keep things consistent across all of your data sets. Hopefully you'll be able to use these in your own work.